Dharma to be fruitful. So fruitfulness is what I call the innobles to the observance of not to tell lies. So in other words, then it's not enough that one abstain from telling lies. One should also develop this noble virtue or the innobles of truthful. Similarly, for each precept, there's one innobles. For example, the first precept, undertake the training of routine. In the noble effort part of this one effective right actions. So right action is to abstain from killing, to abstain from taking what's not given, to abstain from sexual misconduct. These three abstentions correspond to the three precepts. The first precept undertake the training of the king. So the Buddha state lay down the weapons or speak not to take the life of other beings. At the same time, one should develop loving kindness and compassion towards all beings. So the first part of the observant precept is to abstain from killing. Then one should develop these innobles of loving kindness and compassion. Then the second precept undertake the training not to kill. The second precept undertake the training not to take what's not given. Then one should develop the Kalyana Dharma of the innobles of practicing generosity. At the same time, practice patience in earning one's livelihood. It is important to be patient in earning one's livelihood. It's due to impatience, one has strong desire of claiming to become rich in the shortest time possible. For example, to become a billionaire or billionaire in the shortest time possible. Then one may go to the extent of violating the law of companies or moral conducts in order to become rich. That's why it's important to reverse this indolence. Then the third precept undertake the training to restrain or to abstain from sexual misconduct. It also includes sensual misconduct. So here one should develop the innobles of self-restraint and contentment. And the fourth precept, as explained earlier, one undertakes the training not to tell lies. At the same time, one has to develop this innobles of Kalyana Dharma, this truthful. And the fifth precept, one undertakes the training not to drink any intoxicants or taking any drugs such as dana, ganja, and ganja. At the same time, one should develop this noble virtue of the innobles of clarity of mind, to have clarity of mind, and to develop mindfulness watch goodness. So all this fine innovators of Kalyana Dharma enable one to practice all this fine innovators to achieve a spiritual goal, to become a global one. So in other words, by observing these precepts, one could overcome one's conflicts, not only inner conflicts, but conflicts in the society. For example, when one could observe the second precept well, at the same time, could be patient in turning one's mind into even if one cannot remove conflicts totally, one could reduce the conflicts or minimize the conflicts. So the problem of society, for example, sometimes is due to impatience. Due to impatience and due to grief, craving, that's why it may lead to the rising of the views of the society. For example, one of the biggest problems in society is corruption. Similarly, in the observance of practice, in the observance of four precepts, training oneself not to lie, not to tell lies, being truthful. The society, all the people in the society, all the people in the countries, or members of any organization, or members of family, all of them can live in harmony because there's trust between them. But if the people in the society, all the people in the countries, in whatever field they are, whether they are in the business, in the politics, or in other professions, or if the members of any organizations or members of the family are not truthful to each other, but they lie to each other, then when they lie to each other, then gradually the trust among them will be destroyed and advanced because they become suspicious of the words of each other. So in this way, they could not live in harmony. So that's why observance of this precept, not to tell lies and to be truthful, is important. So whoever practice this or develop this noble virtue of truthfulness and not to tell lies, then this person will be able to live in harmony with others. And in that way, he or she is actually give the world the highest blessing, give the world a blessing, or we say a great gift, meaning gift of freedom from fear. This at the same time, it also ennobles his character or the characters by being truthful. So all these